Do you know it's everyone's dream to own a condominium in Singapore, but there's only 20% of the privilege that stays in it? But of course, it requires a huge capital outlay to get into property investment in Singapore. But what if I tell you today that you can buy a new launch condominium with a high capital appreciation and yet still with a recurring income? Before that, let me share with you the 7 steps to buying your first condominium. Let's go! Step 1. Get your finances sorted out. Get an in-principle approval for a bank loan. Total debt servicing ratio of 60%, car loan, credit card loan, and personal loan will affect the amount of loan you are able to get. If you are self-employed, there's a haircut of 30% for your variable income. I would recommend you to go for local banks such as DBS, OCBC, or UOB as their interest rates tend to be more consistent throughout the loan tenure. Next, check your CPF funds. Now all you have to do is pop over to your OA account and see how much you have that can be used to pay for your stamp duty and lawyer fee, and you will ask roughly how much will it be. Just follow this simple calculation, add up your bank loan amount, add up your CPF in your OA account, and lastly, your available cash on hand. Step 2. Explore your options. There are many new launches in Singapore currently. Each project has its own pros and cons. I will advise you to view as many as possible so that you can make an informed choice later on. Step 3. Buying your first property. Choose the unit that you prefer. Pay down 5% deposit fee. Later on, developer will issue you the option to purchase. Step number 4. Engage a lawyer and banker. Lawyer to do the conveyancing while banker will get your option to purchase. Step number 5. Sign the sales and purchase agreement. Within 2 weeks, the developer will deliver the sales and purchase agreement to your law firm. You will have to proceed to exercise the sales and purchase agreement. At the same time, make payment for your stamp duty and lawyer fee and the rest of the progressive payment. Step number 6. Start your progressive payment. Step number 7. When it's TOP, collect your keys. Now that's your guide to purchasing a condominium. Why you should buy a condominium then? I will keep it short. First, you have first mover advantage whereby you enter at developer's price. Second, you have more choices to choose from. Third, you do not have to pay any maintenance fee or property tax during the construction phase. Fourth, if you are able to spot an undervalued project, the capital appreciation will be huge. Lastly, there's also warranty known as the defects liability period. If you are keen to know more or looking to create wealth through property investment, contact me below and I look forward to hearing from you soon.